Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, that popular all-American entertainer, member of the all-star comedy team, Soupy Sales.
You sure know how to make a guy feel good. Thank you. And thank you, Johnny Olson. Right now, it's a pleasure to welcome back to the panel, the second beautiful day of the week, another beautiful lady, Sheila McRae.
Well, I'm wearing my gaucho pants and my sort of gaucho vest for a gentleman who comes way down in South America.
Gaucho Marx.
His name is Gaucho Marx. You told me you'd give me that joke, and you didn't. Alejandro Rey.
The lady I'm about to introduce is a great trombone player, a marvelous actress, but most of all, a beautiful human being, Aline Francis.
Oh, it's nice to have Alejandro here, and it's also nice to always have Wally Bruna here. Yeah.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome all to What's My Line. I think we're going to have a good time because we have something that's designed to stump our panel of experts and put them all to shame, and plus give you a few laughs to go along with it. So if you're set to get the funny happenings underway, good group, let's meet our first challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Dick. Robideau and... Joyce. Not only is it Mr. and Mrs., I believe, but also Dr. and Mrs. And
yes.
Where are you from?
Newton, Iowa.
All right, panel. Dr. and Mrs. Robideau have invented a product. Now, they're going to demonstrate this product right here on stage, but naturally we can't let you see it, so I must ask you to put on your blindfolds, please. So would you put your blindfolds on now? Blindfolds in place? Okay. Mr. and Mrs. Robideau, we'll get all set here to find out just exactly what the product is going to be, and we're going to let, of course, the audience know what it is because they're going to see it done. Now, it takes just a moment or so to fully demonstrate the product panel, and I think, though, we can go ahead and begin the questioning at this particular point. So let's see. Who do we start the questioning with? Well, let's start it with Alejandro Rey.
Okay, thank you. Dick and Joyce. Joyce, I love your name. That's my wife's name. You might be very sweet. This product that you deal with is something, and this is cheating because I'm listening to noises and I have a feeling that you're going to wear something. Something you wear.
Something that they wear?
Yes.
The answer is yes.
Is something that you wear when you do some kind of physical activity.
When they do physical activity?
Yes.
No. No. That's one down. Mm-hmm. Arlene.
Is this something that you both wear, that you both put on together?
Yes, is your answer.
Are you both in the same unit, whatever it is?
Yes.
That's a yes.
Is it something other than a sleeping bag?
Yes.
Yes.
Voices seem strange. Is, does something happen when you are in this thing?
It could, but I don't think... let me say that I better give you a no on that. Nothing better happen, and we'll go on to Super.
Dick and Joyce and Ted and Alice and Bob and Ray. This thing that you're... I heard zippers, and I know you don't make flies, But is this some kind of a coverall that you're wearing?
Yes.
When you are wearing this coverall, that means that it's designed for some kind of action.
What do you mean, action, Soupy?
Well, I mean, like if you're going to jump out of a plane.
Oh, something like that.
It would be like a,
no.
You know.
No. So that's three down, Sheila.
Well, I heard the zippers and sort of rustling of, seemed like some sort of a hard fabric or a laminated fabric. Is this object that you're both in, are your heads sticking out?
Yes.
That's a yes.
Yes? Your heads are sticking out. Are your hands or any part of your fingers sticking out?
No.
No.
They could be.
But they're not. Four down, Alejandro.
This thing that you're wearing is something that will make you change the temperature in your body?
Yes.
Do you have a guess, Alejandro? Our time is up.
It's like a kind of a sauna bath or something like that.
Sauna bath, no.
No, but is it a reducing...
No.
Can I guess?
Yes.
It's one of those blankets you wear at a football game.
That's close enough. Yes. It's a stadium set. Okay, you think you can feel out of it? Joy from Rick. There we go. And come on back and join me. And that's quite an outfit. Can you tell me how this all came about?
At a Viking-Dallas Cowboy game, we were freezing, and we thought there must be a better answer to watching a football game than what we were experiencing. So we came home, and you tell.
We drew up a pattern and laid it on the living room floor and took it from there and designed it.
It's very. And now, does it really keep you warm?
Oh.
Yes.
It surely does.
I was just last Sunday in Mexico City watching the bullfightings, and it was raining, and the bull didn't quit, so we didn't feel like quitting, but we needed something like that to be there watching.
Well, they wear those at a bar that I go to because one of the waiters has St. Vitus dance.
It's an amazing thing how many things are invented because somebody who is not exactly a business person thought of them. I think it's fantastic.
Right.
What average people can do.
Well, the doctor is a dentist, and of course, you, I don't believe you're employed, are you, Joyce? You're,
no, housewife.
You're a homemaker.
Housewife, that's fantastic.
But panel, do any of you have any idea what might be coming next?
A fashion show.
Well, in a way, because we're going to have a stadium sack contest.
Oh.
So, Lloyd, will you open the curtain, please? And panel, will you join me, please, center stage?
This is the dream of my life.
Now, what we're going to do, we're going to make up two teams, Alejandro and Arlene, right over here with the red, Soupy and Sheila with the green, please. Now, what we're going to do, don't do anything yet. You both have to get into the stadium sack. And the first one to get into the stadium sack, have it zippered up and the hood over your head and everything in place and completely finished, we'll each get a stadium sack to take home.
So this is the dream
ready,
of my
together. Ready, you have to get in together. Ready, set, go. Hurry! Zip it up! All right, it's Arlene and Alejandro.
Would you please keep it down? I'm in here voting.
You know, that looks very, very cozy, Dick. I'm sure that it's a lot of fun going to a football game like that.
It really is.
But thank you both, you and Joyce, for joining us on What's My Line.
Thank you.
What's My Line will continue right after this one. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Well, that was fun. And Arlene, you say it was really quite warm?
Oh, it was as cozy as it could be, but I think my Latin lover had something to do with that.
My little Red Riding Hood.
Pardon?
With my little Red Riding Hood.
Yes.
Sheila, I'm sorry we teamed you up with an old Navy man. You know, they never did know how to work zippers. But still, I think you'll all get a stadium sack to take home with you.
Oh, they're heaven. I loved it.
But now let's meet another challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Joe. Blasco. Mr. Blasco, where are you from?
New York City.
All right, panel, Joe Blasco is the organizer of a special cruise for a particular group of people. And now let's show the audience just what kind of cruise it is. Remind you, it's a special cruise for a particular group of people, and we'll begin with Sheila McRae.
A special cruise is C-R-U-I-S-E.
Right.
Not cruise like here.
Right.
All right. This cruise that Mr. Blasco organizes, it has persons of both sexes?
Yes, it does.
I was going to say all three sexes. Both sexes. Is there an age limit?
No, there isn't.
To the sex?
There one down, Alejandro.
These groups that you organized have any physical handicaps?
Not as such, no.
Two down, Arlene.
Is the cruise specially oriented to certain places, specific places?
You mean
does that make
port
any
of calls?
Difference? Yes, ports of call.
Yeah, but it has no bearing on it.
Three down, Soupy.
The reason that this is unusual, Mr. Blasco, is it because of the function of it? I mean, like, of who you're going to get together on that cruise? Is that help?
Yes, yes.
This is one of the smoothest crossings I've ever been.
It's awfully nice for this time of year, isn't it?
Would it help if we found out what kind of people are going to be on this cruise?
Yes.
There are a lot of ads in the paper on the weekends about swinging singles. Does it have anything to do with that?
Nothing.
No? Four down, Sheila.
Well, let's see, not swinging singles, and it's male and female. It doesn't matter about their age. Would some of these people have a weight problem?
No.
Well, they might have, but that is not. Five down, Alejandro.
Why don't I get straight lines like that?
Alejandro.
These people are something other than single people, right?
Could be couples, yes.
But they are not married people, are they?
They are.
Most
not
of them are, yes.
Could be?
Yes.
They are not married people?
No.
No.
No. Six down, Arlene.
They are not married people, no. What does that mean?
That means that the no, some of them are married and some of them aren't married.
So it's a mixed group, whatever it is. Are they also mixed ages?
Yes.
Do they, however, have something in common, all
yes,
these people?
Definitely.
Are they all interested in a particular game of some kind? Do they have a contest on board?
No.
No. Does anyone have a guess?
Is this for the governors?
No.
Is it for students?
No. It's a stop smoking cruise. Mr. Blasco is the founder of the Institute for New Motivations, which is organizing the first stop smoking cruise for people who want to kick the habit. And I guess the purpose of the cruise is obvious.
Very obvious.
Yeah, but the only trouble is that you get out there for 3 or 4 days, all they're going to be doing is hollering man overboard all day long.
They're hating each other, I'm sure,
well,
right?
Well, how do you plan to do this, Mr. Blasco?
Well, by creating a very special environment, which will not only be enjoyable, but also a very effective way not only to stop smoking, but stop wanting to smoke. We have a group of psychiatrists and psychologists on board, seven altogether. And we have a very special program designed just for that purpose.
Have you done it once already? Are you going to undertake it?
We have worked individually with smaller groups of people, yes.
And has it worked all right?
Oh, definitely.
Do they drink more?
On all cruises, people drink more, yes. That's the idea, that you're going to have a lot of fun.
Well, now, what about the crew? Is the crew going to smoke in front of the passengers?
No. As a matter of fact, a lot of the crew members have joined us in the program. And the ones that haven't agreed not to smoke front of the passengers.
Now, how much does it cost?
$695 and up, depending on your commendations.
Well, you know, now you, as you say, you must make ports of call. What about when they get off the ship?
That's the whole idea. After 3.5 days, they'll have a chance to test themselves the first time.
Oh, boy.
Well,
we're very confident. No problems.
Marvelous, really.
All right, well, you stumped the panel and won the game, and we're delighted you could join us on What's My Line.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
We'll be back to meet a mystery challenger as What's My Line continues. And here we are again at the very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest panel. Are those blindfolds really in place?
They're here.
They're there and securely in place, all right? The blindfolds. So let's meet our mystery challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? It's one question at a time. I'll give you 3 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and let's begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Wally. Mystery guest, would we find your name in the entertainment sections of the newspaper?
Yes.
Sheila.
Sounds like a female.
It's Minnie Mouse.
Are you mainly seen on television?
Yes.
Alejandro?
Are you a regular in a television show?
Yes.
Arlene?
Is it a domestic series?
You mean domestic as opposed
family
to
series?
United States or yes or
no, I mean family as opposed to feudal.
Right.
No.
Soupy.
Oh, is it a variety show?
No.
What?
No.
No.
Sheila.
If it's not family, not variety, is it one of the very good series dealing with law and the breaking of laws?
No.
Alejandro.
Is it a comedy situation? Series?
No.
Not really. Arlene?
Well, is it a children's show?
You mean do children like it?
Is it especially geared to children?
No.
Soupy.
Is it a talk show?
You mean do people talk on it? No, you mean the classic thing.
No.
Sheila.
Is it a show that combines a mysterious influence? In other words, you're working for an unknown government.
An unknown government?
Yeah. I mean, it's not stated, the name.
Let's say there's a mysterious influence, but there's no unknown government.
Okay. No.
Alejandro.
Are you by any chance in a daytime serial?
No.
Arlene.
Is it a once a week program?
No.
Soupy?
No, wait a minute.
I think we have you stumped.
Wait a minute.
Well, wait a minute.
I don't have a minute. I have about 10 seconds.
Darn.
Do you have a guess?
Is it a news show?
No.
Oh.
Take off your blindfolds and meet Peggy Cass. Peggy, I see a protest flag up on the panel. Soupy?
No, I thought it was Peggy, but your voice is cleared up. Of course, a panel show is a talk show.
But he said, yeah, but we're not.
But not what you consider.
Yeah, I think a panel show is really a panel show. A talk show is more.
I didn't come here to argue.
Don't let him fight.
That's right. You're marvelous.
But while we're on a controversial subject, and of course we're talking about to tell the truth, right?
Which yes. Is not
a
yes.
Which is seen 5 nights a week in most of the major cities and
the smaller ones
and
the villages
ones too,
and
the villages and the hamlets and it's a delightful show.
Thank you.
Hey, I saw Peggy in Plaza Suite, and if you haven't seen that with Peggy Cass, you see it. She's fantastic. You're
Thank
marvelous
you.
In that.
True. Thank you.
So is Don Porter and the other people, but
Thank
you're
you.
Marvelous.
Peggy, you know, you've never really hedged on anything anyone ever asked you. You know, you just sort of laid on the line. What about women's lib? How do you stand?
Well, I think that women should get the same amount of money for the same amount of work. If they do the same amount of work as a man, I think they should be paid the same amount. But I think that women look foolish marching down the street burning I think that all that stuff about burning bras is foolish. Most of those girls should look in the mirror. They need them.
Right.
believe in daycare centers. I believe in all those things. But I think sometimes they go to such, like, weird, kind of far-out things to make their point. They don't need it.
You still like to have a guy open the door for
oh,
you?
Oh, my dear, and how? After all, I'm the one who always carries the packages. He's got to do something.
Well, what about the mini and the maxi thing?
Oh, I love the midi. I love it. I'm crazy about it.
The midi?
Yes.
You don't like the mini?
Oh, I love the mini, too. I like a lot of clothes. That's really what it boils down to.
Well, Peggy, we like you, and we're always delighted when you can
thank
join
you.
Us. So much, my wife.
Thank you very much.
Peggy Katz. What's My Line will continue right after this week. And a very special welcome this week to Alejandro Rey. Alejandro, I understand you have very strong opinions about women's lib.
Yeah, I didn't want to start an argument with Peggy because I love her. But I am completely for the women liberations. I think they are asking for more things that they should, but all movements should ask for more. Because
well, there's a lot of movement with the gals that are for women's lib. You ought to see them walking down the street.
I think it's about time that we realize that women are exactly the same as we are. They are not inferior. They never were. And they can prove themselves that they can do jobs as well as we do, scientifically, as doctors, as lawyers. And it's fantastic. And it's amazing that I found myself defending women with women. And they've been told for so many years that they are not as good as we are. And when we tell them that they are, you know, as good, they laugh. The time will be, and we are going to be completely equal without women losing their
femininity.
This
is quite a session, but thank you, Alejandro Rey. Well, I think that sort of wraps up another session on this particular Tuesday. And once again, the marks were rather good, don't you think,
well,
Soupy?
I tell you, women will do until they come up with something better, I tell
you. Oh, that's right.
I don't think anyone's going to argue with that, even Alejandro, right?
Right.
Okay, and join us tomorrow, won't you please, for What's My Life?
Survey said.
Family Feud. Sounds like fun, doesn't it? Weekdays at noon and 5:30 Eastern on Game Show Network.